नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्यासंप्रदायकर्तृभ्यो श्रीमद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरेचः प्रज्ञानयः प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यम् तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ हुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरीसहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहं आशुहरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्
So we are looking at the objections to the difference between Yushmat Pratyaya Gochara Anatma and Asmat Pratyaya Gochara Atma. So we have looked at some of the refutations of the objections raised by the Purvapakshi. So when Chidatmaka was mentioned, why was it mentioned? It was mentioned to take away the confusion about Pratyaktvam being possible in the case of Anatma also. Therefore, Paraktvam and Pratyaktvam having Virodha with each other was objected to by the Purvapakshi. However, that objection is invalidated by showing the flaw in the Tarka as to Mukhya Pratyaktvam is there for Anatma also, said the Purvapakshi. Why? Because it is also Ahamiti Bhasamana. So Ahamiti Bhasamana Tvat was his Hetu, which was shown to be Dushita Hetu. Thereby, the refutation of that kind of a Dushtarka was done. And this is indicated by showing that this Pratyagatma, Asmat Pratyagochara, on which there is no possibility of adhyasa of anatma, because anatma is jada, it cannot be chidatmaka, it cannot be chit swarupa. That was shown by using the word chidatmake in the adhyasa bhashya. Now the tikakara explains this further. So the tikakara said अनवच्छिन्नत्वं अपरिच्छिन्नत्वं व्यापकत्वं इति यावत् देन अहंकारः मुख्य प्रत्यक्त्वादिमान् दिस वाज दी तर्क गिवन इन दी रत्नप्रभा बाय दी पूर्वपक्षी वी सॉ दैट यस्टरडे बट इन दी टीका देयर आर सम मोर डिटेल सो अहंकार मुख्य प्रत्यक्त्वादिमान् अहम् इति भास्यत्वात् आत्मवद् इति प्रयोगे इन दिस ऑब्जेक्शन दैट इज मेड विद द अनुमान अहंकार ऑल्सो हैज Mukhya Pratyakto, meaning it is also primarily used in the sense of being inward. Okay, it is, but not primarily. It is used in the sense of inward when you are talking about the Sharira or Vishaya, Deha. So here the example uses Deha Sharira, Manishyattvam. Like the Atma, it is inward if you say. It isn't like the Atma inward. It is inward, but not when you say it is inward and a Vishayi. Also, it isn't, unlike Atma. So he says, Ahamiti Bhasyatvad Atmavat. लाइक आत्मा इन दैट प्रयोग अहमिति भाष्यत्वं किम केवल अहंकार केवल अहंकार आकारित वृत्ति भाष्यत्वं और अहम आकारित साक्षी भाष्यत्वं वा इति विकल्प्य हेतु दूषणे भाष्याशयं स्फुटीकरोति अहम वृत्ति इति सो दी स्फुटीकरोति सॉरी स्फुटीकरोति एंड देन अहम वृत्ति इज अ सेपरेट सेंटेंस सो the Ratnaprabhakara is differentiating between this hetu that has been given, not the hetu but mukhya pratyektwadi man, that sadhya that you are trying to bring in with the hetu ahamiti bhasyatvam. That ahamiti bhasyatvam hetu is divided into two. Whether you mean the keval ahankara akarita vritti, भाष्यत्वम् दि भाष्यत्वम् इज व्हाट वृत्ति भाष्यत्वम् इज इट वृत्ति भाष्यत्वम् बाय दि केवल अहंकार आकार इज इट दैट व्हेन यू से अहम् इति भाष्यत्वम् इज इट केवल अहंकार आकार वृत्ति भाष्यत्वम् और इज इट अहम् आकारित साक्षी भाष्यत्वम् is that ahankara sakshi bhasya as that there is bhasyamanatvam or is it kevala ahankara akara vritti bhasyatvam if you say the earlier meaning kevala ahankara akarita vritti bhasyatvam and this is all in the bhashya so bhashya ashaya is this when bhagwan bhashyakara is separating these two and showing virodha he has this in his mind So, bhashyashayam sputikaroti. Whatever is the idea is in the bhashya, that is clarified by Ratnaprabhakara by saying that aham vritti iti, that aham vritti that you talk of is in the Ratnaprabha, what has mentioned aham vritti iti bhava pradana nirdesha. So, the bhava pradana tasya bhava. So, you have to use aham vrittitvam. Ahantvam, aham vrittitvam. That idea. So, bhava pradana nirdesha parinama rupa vrittyashrayatva. वृत्ति विषयत्व स्वरूपयोः कर्तृ कर्तृत्व कर्मत्व योर एक एकस्य अहंकारस्य विरोधः सो कर्तृ कर्म विरोधः वाज मेंशन्ड व्हाट इज दैट कर्तृ कर्म विरोधः कर्तृ कर्तृत्व एंड कर्मत्व विरोधः इज देयर इट कैन नॉट बी देयर इन द सेम अहंकार सो यू कैन से कर्तृत्व कर्मत्वयोः एके अहंकारे ऑल्सो विरोधात और एकस्य अहंकारस्य विरोधात सो इन द सेम अहंकार सो आई ट्रांसलेट इन द सेम अहंकार यू कैन नॉट हैव कर्तृत्वम ऑल्सो एंड कर्मत्वम ऑल्सो व्हाट इज दिस कर्तृत्वम एंड कर्मत्वम सो परिणाम रूप वृत्ति आश्रयत्वम परिणाम रूप दिस अहम वृत्ति परिणाम इज टेकिंग प्लेस सो परिणाम रूप वृत्ति The ahankara itself is taking the parinama in the form of vritti. Vritti is not separate from antakkarana. In fact, it is the same antakkarana which takes the shape of the ghata ityadi, ghatakara vritti. Similarly, ahamakara vritti is also there. Brahmakara vritti is also there. So this ahamakara vritti in this case, ahamiti bhasyatvam, there ahamakara vritti is there of the same antakkarana. Therefore, parinama rupa vritti, Ashrayatvam, if you say, then Antakkarana entire has not transformed itself into vritti. And in the usage, what do we say? Oh, there is a vritti in the Antakkarana. So, thereby Ashrayatvam is there. Antakkarana is Ashraya for this vritti. Although Antakkarana vritti itself is a transformation, but we say that it is in the Antakkarana. Vritti takes place in the Antakkarana. So, if we are saying that there is a We differentiate between the vritti and the ahankara in that case. What happens that vritti ashrayatva, you will be seeing it as an ashraya. The same antakkarana which is vritti. So if it has become the ashraya for what? To hold the vishaya. What is the vishaya? Same antakkarana again. This vritti, antakkarana vritti is the ashraya also. And it is also the adheya, vishayatva. Vishaya, it is also the vishaya. So vishayatva and ashrayatva, So, vritti is a vishaya and vritti is an vritti ashraya is antakkarana. But antakkarana itself is vritti. So, now you cannot have vishayatva and ashrayatva. That is a kartrukarma virodha is seen in another manner, explained in another manner. Thereby, the swarupa of the antakarana is that it takes parinama. Not swarupa, swabhava. Swarupa is that which doesn't change really. So we can say swabhava of antakarana is to transform itself in the form of vritti based on the vishaya. So vritti itself cannot be the vishaya, antakarana itself cannot be the vishaya, ahankara. Antakarana here is in sense of ahankara role. That is the kartrukarmatva. Kartrukarma virodha or kartrutva karmatva yoho ekasya ahankarasya virodha ityartha or ekasmin ahankare virodha ityartha. Athava, otherwise another interpretation is kartrukarmanoho paraspara aikya yogyatva rupa virodhasya sattvad ityartha. So now you don't look at the dharmas, you don't look at the bhava pradhana nirdesha. You read into this kartru and karma, not kartrutva and karmatva, but kartru karma paraspara cannot become one. Mutually they cannot become one. Karta cannot be karma, karma cannot be karta. Same idea said in a different, in a simpler language than the Nayayika's adhara adhya bhava. Therefore, kartru karmano paraspara aikya yogyatva rupa virodhasya sattvadityartha. These two which are opposite cannot be one with each other. You cannot have the same karta being the karma. Just like you cannot stand on your own shoulders. Although there are avayavas there, we mean that the same entity cannot stand on one's own shoulders looking at it as a single person. Ahankarasya sakshibhasyattvam na chidvyatirikta vrittibhasyattvam. So simplified, the sum total is mentioned. Ahankarasya sakshibhasyattvam na chidvyatirikta vrittibhasyattvam anyata karma kartrutva virodha syad iti bhava. So what is the idea? That ahankara is known. When you say ahankara is known, aham iti bhasyamanattvam, bhasyattvam. Aham iti bhasyattvam that you talk about, that is not by itself. Ahankara is lit up by the sakshi chaitanya. So sakshi bhasyattvam asti ahankare, and there is a bhranti that the ahankara is sentient. It has its own light. This is a bhranti, whereas it is lit up by the chaitanya, sakshi chaitanya, just like a mirror lit up by a sun or a different source of light shines forth, and we think that that itself is the source of light. So if you see from a distance, if the mirror isn't moving, if it is kept like that, then we see prakasha there. When someone moves the mirror, then you know that, maybe it is a mirror that somebody is reflecting light off it. Otherwise, it looks like the original source of light. So that is the bhranti. Brahmaha ahankara sakshibhasyattvam na chidvyatirikta. It is not that vritti bhasyattvam that you talk about. Ahamiti bhasyattvam is vritti. Ahamiti, by ahamiti, what is meant? Ahankara vritti. Aham akarika vritti. So that vritti is not lit up on its own. Chidvyatirikta bhasyattvam vrittav nasti. So chidvyatirikta vritti bhasyattvam na anyatha, otherwise what will happen? Again same thing. Karma kartrutva virodha syaditi bhava. So whether you say kartrukarma virodha, karma kartru virodha, or you say kartrutva karmatva virodha, or you take this tva pratyaya and put it at the end and say karma kartrutva virodha, all mean the same idea in the end. Svaprakashatmani karma kartrutva virodha deva na chidbhasyattvam ityaha chidbhasyattvam iti. So svaprakashatmani, now if you look at the svaprakashatma, which is sakshi chaitanya, there don't you have karma kartru virodha? Oh, there also there can be an objection of karma kartru virodha. If you say that the chaitanya lights itself up, we don't say that karmatvena lights itself up, we say that it is svaprakasha. Just like the lamp does not need to light itself up. The lamp which is lit up, the light of the lamp does not need to light itself up. The light is seen and ends up lighting up everything in its presence by its mere svabhava. Similarly, chaitanya is svaprakasha. Therefore, there is no kartrukarma virodha there. So, svaprakashatmani karma kartrutva virodha devana chidbhasyattvam ityahas. So chidbhasyatvam is not there in chit. Chit is saprakasha. There is no chidbhasyatvam. Anya chit. If you say anya chit, there is no other chit. If you say the same chit lights up the this chit, then there is karma kartru viroda. If you take anya chit lights up this chit, there is no chaitanya other than this brahma chaitanya, sakshi chaitanya. But if someone were to argue hypothetically, no, we don't agree with this advaita tattva, we say that there are as many chaitanyas as there are jivas, and there is ishvara chaitanya separate. There is these devata chaitanyas are also separate from the this samsari jiva chaitanya, rakshasa chaitanya, all these are, meaning their own sakshi chaitanyas are separate. If someone were to argue, then we'll tell him that if one chaitanya needs another chaitanya to light it up, then what about that second chaitanya? There also there is, for that chaitanya also you will have to say that there is aham iti bhasyatvam. Then what about that chaitanya? How is it known? Then you will have to bring a third one. For that third, you have to bring a fourth, and there will be infinite regress. So there will be anavastha dosha. And thereby advaitins, anyway, we say that there is only one chaitanya, and saprakasha chaitanya, there is no karma kartu virodha there. Otherwise, chidbhasyatvam, had it been there in chit itself, then there would be karma kartu virodha. Prativhasata bhranti rupa pratyakshena ityartha. So what was said there is, as the pratibhasa which was talked about, it appears so. It appears ahamiti bhasyatvam in the ahankara is a brahma. So bhranti rupa pratyakshena. It is pratyaksha, but it is not yathartha anubhava. Pratyaksha jnana is anubhava, but it can be bhranti also. Pratyaksha it is, like the sarpa. Sarpa is pratyaksha to the person who is seeing instead of the rajju. So Rajju Sarpa is also Pratyaksha, but not as Rajju Sarpa. It is Pratyaksha as Sarpa. However, once one has Pratyaksha of the same Rajju Sarpa, Sarpa as Rajju, then the Sarpa is no longer there. Therefore, it is Badhita. It is not Abadhita. Therefore, it is not Prama. It is Aprama. It is not a Yathartha Anubhava. It is Ayathartha Anubhava. Therefore, it is a Bhranti or a Brahma. So bhranti rupa pratyaksham is possible in the ahankara as ahamiti, and thereby that bhasyatvam of chit from the sakshi chit, it being lit up, can be confusing, can be veiled, and therefore it can be confused to be originally of the ahankara. Ahankarasya mukhya pratyaktvadikam nirasya. Having refuted this ahankara being inward, primarily, when you say inward, it's a relative inwardness compared to the Vishaya and compared to the Sharira, but there is no stopping there. You have to go further. Even Ahankara should not be seen as Aham. It should be dropped as a Kosha. It is not Atma. Anyontara Atma, which is what? Again, this either Vijnanamaya, and then from Vijnanamaya, you go to Anandamaya. And so on. प्रत्यक्त्वादिकं सो निरस्य अहंकारस्य मुख्य प्रत्यक्त्वादिकं निरस्य पराक्त्वादिकं साधयन् देन इट इज आउटवर्ड दिस अहंकार इज आउटवर्ड विज्ञानमय कोश इज आउटवर्ड साधयन् कर्मधारयन् ज्ञापयति एंड देयरफॉर इट इज अ कर्मधारय हाउ इज इट शोन सो यू गो टू दी रत्नप्रभा नाउ सो अहम इति ऑल दिस इज डन या सो युष्मत सो देयर युष्मद इति ज्ञापयति युष्मद इति युष्मत is parak. What is meant by you here is idam. And what is that idam? Idam is ahankaradi anatma, and that is parak, that is outward. So parak cha aso pratiyate iti pratyaha cha aso kartrutvadi vyavahara gocharasya tasya iti vigraha. So karmadhara is this yushmat. Yushmat cha aso pratyascha aso vyavahara gocharasya. Or gocharascha. Vyavahara is not mentioned there. Yushmaccha asau pratyascha asau gocharascha iti karmadharaya vigraha. So thereby you will get what? Therefore yushmat pratyaya gocharaha. And then you decline it in whichever case. So what is the meaning? We have already seen this in Ratna Prabha also and the Tika also. Parak युष्मत मीन्स पराग आउटवर्ड. देन प्रत्यय, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रत्यय इन द केस ऑफ युष्मत, देर इट इज प्रतीयते इति प्रत्यय. इट्स अ कर्मणि व्युत्पत्ति, इट्स एन ऑब्जेक्ट नॉट अ सब्जेक्ट, इट इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट, इट इज नॉट ज्ञान रूप, इट इज अनात्म एंड अज्ञान कार्य. प्रतीयते, इट अपीयर्स टू बी देर, दृश्यत्वात् मिथ्या. फर्दर एंड दैट इज ऑल्सो वॉट गोचर, हाउ इज इट गोचर, व्यवहार गोचर, व्यवहार इज पॉसिबल. वॉट इज दिस व्यवहार, कर्तृत्वादि व्यवहार इन द केस ऑफ अहंकार. सो वेन एवर देर इज अहम इति भाष्यत्व, इट कम्स अलॉन्ग विद दैट अहम इति कर्ता, आई एम दिस मनुष्य, आई एम अ कर्ता, आई हैव थिंग्स टू डू, आई हैव अ ड्यूटी टू परफॉर्म, वर्णाश्रम धर्म, अदरवाइज आई वॉन्ट टू हेल्प समवन आउट, आई वॉन्ट टू गेट दिस रिजल्ट, सो आई एम अ भोक्ता. हाउ विल आई डू इट, ईदर बाय यू नो बीइंग अ श्रोता मंता एटसेट्रा. देर फोर व्यवहार गोचरत्व इज डिफरेंट, इट इज कर्तृत्वादि व्यवहार गोचरत्व इन द केस ऑफ युष्मत् प्रत्यय गोचर अनात्म. तस्य हेयत्वार्थम आह विशेष्यति, एंड व्हाट इज इट, इट इज विषय. सो तस्य कस्य, तस्य युष्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरस्य, युष्मत् प्रत्यय गोचर हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड एज कर्मधारय. देन इन षष्ठी तस्य युष्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरस्य विषयस्य, इट इज अ विषय. एंड व्हाई इज द वर्ड विषय नीडेड, इट्स एन ऑब्जेक्ट, दैट ऑब्जेक्ट शुड बी गिवन अप, ऑल परस्यूट्स ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट शुड बी गिवन अप, एंड देन द सब्जेक्ट विल स्टॉप बीइंग अ सब्जेक्ट. आत्मा इज अभिव्यक्त मैनिफेस्ट एज द सब्जेक्ट ओनली व्हेन देयर इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट टू डील विथ, अदरवाइज द आत्मा हैज नथिंग टू डू विथ इट. द चिदात्मा इज शुद्ध साक्षी, नॉट इवन अ साक्षी रियली, साक्षी इज टू टेल यू दैट इट इज नॉट अ सब्जेक्ट. So when you say witness, then witness has nothing to do with the kriya which is going on, whether it is for good or bad. So there is a karta involved, there is a karma involved. So there is a subject-object division everywhere. But as soon as you are a witness to it, you are neither the karta, you are nor the, neither the karta nor the vishaya. Neither the vishayi nor the vishaya. Neither the subject nor the object. So you are a witness. This sakshi shabda should be used only to separate yourself out from the pramata or the karta bhokta. Once you have separated yourself from the karta bhokta, then this sakshi term can be dropped because there is nothing as sakshya also. Once it is understood, the word can still be used, but you should understand that there is sakshi shabda also in connection with sakshya. If you take it literally, then it is only when there is something to be witnessed. The witness prapancha includes this kartrutva bhava, bhoktrutva bhava, so pramatrutvam in atma is mithya. Kartrutva bhoktrutva is mithya. Therefore, there is nothing to witness also. As long as it is there, you are a witness, you separate yourself out. So it is a sadhana that I am not a karta bhokta, I am a sakshi. I have nothing to do with them. So I am an asanga atma. This is how the process is to use. Use this word sakshi and understand it. Once you understand, the sakshi shabda has no meaning per se, because sakshi has a sakshi kasya sakshi, sakshyasya sakshi, sakshya is mithya, so you cannot be in the real sense called as sakshi also. Anyway, that's an aside. So tasya heyatvartham ah, the object has to be dropped. It should be dropped, each and every pursuit of the object as being the source of ananda, because every pursuit has a hidden hunt for ananda hidden within, embedded within. Every pursuit has in its garbha, it has this ananda as its goal, as its basis. It should be dropped because there is no ananda outside. It is manifest outside because of the craving dropping once you have some kind of satisfaction with the object, gaining the object, etc. It takes away the craving, it takes away the distance from that ananda, which is your own ananda. And then because it, by kakatalya nyaya, a crow comes in and sits on a coconut tree, the crow is asamartha to drop the coconut, but still the coconut drops at that point of time. So what do you think? generally we'll say, oh, the you know, the crow sat there and the coconut fell. So the crow dropped the coconut. The crow didn't drop the coconut. It is illogical. So what's the fact? It is just a coincidence. So kakatali and nyaya. Similarly, here there is a coincidence by kakatali and nyaya that the vishaya goes away. The craving, kama, raga towards the vishaya goes away. Or the vishaya goes away where you had the dvesha. So dvesha vishaya goes away or raga vishaya is obtained. Then what happens is there is a bhranti because the ananda sinks up there, not because of vishaya prapti, but because of that raga dvesha nivritti. So raga dvesha nivritti takes away your distance from yourself as though. Because we are involved in the antakkarana and there is a bahya pravritti. Paranji khani vyatrana swayambhu said Kathopanishad. So Bhagavan has created us like that, and it is said figuratively, it is poetically mentioned that as though Bhagavan having created us in this manner that we go towards the vishayas, indriyas are turned outside, paranji khani, they are all parak. All the indriyas are focused outwards. They are not withdrawn. By themselves, they are not withdrawn. As soon as the kid is born, that child looks outward, tries to hear outward, and then sleeps off. But then wants to have bhoga of everything around in every manner through all the indriyas. Because the indriyas are tuned outward by their very swabhava. And what is the swabhava? Bhagavan gave it. So then you start blaming the Bhagavan. So the Kathopanishad has a satire there. It's like a satire. It says that, oh, Bhagavan destroyed. This is a jiva's thinking. Bhagavan destroyed all the jivas by making the indriyas tuned outwards. In fact, this is the argument given by these charvakas. The new age charvakas. They say, oh, if the Lord is there, let him show himself to me. He is missing a devotee in my form. So the onus is on him to prove his existence. So all these people, they are kings. They want every Bhagavan also to become their servant. To claim that I am the Lord and then you become my servant. So this is all bogus thinking. You know, one-upmanship that I am a logical thinker. I have a scientific upbringing and all that nonsense is there. And similarly, what do they say? You know, if you say the Lord is ever compassionate and all that, then what is this? He is not giving me mukti. He is making all my indriyas tune outwards. Like Duryodhana saying, you know, you are the one who within you prod me to go outward and do all this dushkarma. So you blame the Lord for everything. So this person who is saying that, he is, you know, his thinking is paraphrased there in Kathopanishad, and then as though destroyed, really did not destroy. This is what we wanted tattat anubhava, therefore Bhagavan has made our indriyas focus outwards by his compassion so that we get what we want. And then Pariksha Loka and elsewhere it says that now you know that even if your indriyas go to the vishaya, still you get the vishaya also, what happens? Sukha is not nitya. You get the sukha that is manifest due to raga dvesha nivritti. Therefore, what should be done to hold on to this ananda, make it nitya? It cannot be done with vishaya anubhava. Therefore, vishaya has heyatvam. So, tasya heyatva artham aha vishayasyeti. This yushmat pratyaya gochara, whatever is drishya, and darshana being upalakshana there. Whatever is Shravya, Ityadi, all those are what? They are all here. They should be given up. Tika, Ahankaraha Mukhya Paraktva Vaan, Pratyamanatvad, Gocharatvad, Va, iti Sadhaniyam. And then this Yushmat Pratyaya, this Parak, was mentioned here, but before that, Parak Pratyaktvam was talked about. That Pratyaktvam is refuted. But then here he gives another hetu there, ahankara mukhya paraktvavan. So pratyaktvam, the hetu was given, and that in objection for that मुख्य प्रत्यक्त्वम वाज गिवन एंड इट वाज रिफ्यूटेड, बट फॉर पराक्त्वम देयर इज नो हेतु गिवन. सो अहंकार बीइंग इनवर्ड वाज द आर्ग्यूमेंट ऑफ द पूर्व पक्षी विथ अ हेतु. नाउ इफ यू से इट इज आउटवर्ड, व्हाट इज द सिद्धांत इज हेतु, सो दैट इज नॉट गिवन हियर पर्टिकुलरली. सी युष्मत् पराक, दैट्स ऑल द रत्नप्रभाकर सेज. सो इफ इट इज नॉट प्रत्यक देन इट इज पराक. दैट इज द सिंप्लिसिटी ऑफ रत्नप्रभाकर. टीकाकर हैज अ रोल टू प्ले. ही सेज दैट हेतु इज नॉट गिवन, लेट मी सप्लाय. सो अहंकार मुख्य पराक्त्ववान, नॉट मुख्य प्रत्यक्त्ववान, दैट हैज बीन refuted. So ahankara is outward in the primary sense of the word, outward. So ahankara mukhya paraktovan, why? Pratiyamanatvat, gocharatvat, va iti sadhaniyam. So hetu should be either given as pratiyamanatvat, drishyatvat ityartha. So it appears as an object. You cannot be the object, therefore it is outward to you. That is one way to look at it. So yatra yatra pratiyamanatvam tatra tatra mukhya paraktvam. Similarly, gocharatvat, this gocharatvam is kartratvadi gocharatvam. So karta bhokta, that kind of idea is there. So ahankara is doing it. Ahankara is doing guna guneshu vartante iti matva na sajjate. So kaha na sajjate? Vidvan na sajjate. One does not, the vidvan who knows this, that I am different from this antakkarana and the indriyas who have their own vishayas and they deal with them as per the prarabdha. Things are going on. When I want something to get done, I get involved with it and then claim ownership, claim to be a karta bhokta. But otherwise, this kartrutvam is not there in me. It is a ahankara antargata dharma, of course with me backing, but then it is an ahankara dharma and thereby gocharatvam vyavahara gocharatvam is there. Therefore, yatra yatra kartrutvadi vyavahara gocharatvam. So, you cannot say yatra yatra. Kartrutva, instead of kartrutva, you can bring in other. Like say, pramatrutva, vyavahara gocharatvam, shrotrutva, shrota. So, shrotrutva will be there. So, these dharmas can be brought in. Each role of the karta can be brought in as a subject. In what manner? Are you a hearer? Are you a speaker? Are you a seer? Are you a taster? So therefore, those dharmas can be brought in. And tattad dharma avachinna ahankara vyavahara gocharattum. So therefore, those kind of vyavahara gocharattum can be brought in. And then paraktum can be established as mukhya. विषय नाम, व्हाट इज दिस विषय, विषयस्य विषयो नाम बंध हेतु इत्याह. सो व्हाई इज देयर हेयत्वम, व्हाई शुड यू ड्रॉप विषय, बिकॉज विषय विल बाइंड यू. हाउ डू यू नो, हाउ डू यू नो, यू कैन नो इवन बाय द वर्ड बाय व्याकरण यू कैन नो. देयरफॉर इशो शिन बंधने इति. व्हाट इज इट व्युत्पत्ति ऑफ विषय, व्हाट इज इट धातु यूज, वी पूर्वक शिन धातु एंड द शिन धातु इज इन बंधन अर्थ. सो बंधने, बंधने विषय चिंधा धातु. सो वी पूर्वक सिंधातु एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ बंधन इट इज, विशेष विशेषेण बध्नाति. इट बाइंड्स यू इन अ वेरी स्पेसिफिक मैनर. एंड व्हाट इज दैट स्पेसिफिक मैनर? इट डजंट लेट यू गो एवर. दैट विषय एज लॉन्ग यू होल्ड ऑन टू इट, लाइक अ मंकी वी होल्ड ऑन टू द फ्रूट इन अ नैरो नेक पॉट. दिस इज द नेचर ऑफ विषय ऑल्सो. Like a phala, it lies in a narrow-necked mouth of this prapancha, samsara. As soon as we hold on to it, we get stuck. Therefore, it's a very swabhava. Vishaya, vishayasya, kasya vishayasya? Bandhana kartru rupa vishayasya. So you can think that it is going to bind you. Badhnati. विसिनोति बध्नाति इति विषयः. सो विथ वी पूर्वक इट विल बिकम विसिनोति. शिन धातु, सो धात्वादेश सः. सो शकार इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द धातु विल बिकम सकार. इट इज रियली सकार इन द धातु पाठ. इट हैज बीन मेड मूर्धन्य. वंस इट कम्स आउट to be used sorry in the vyutpatti of any word, then that shin will become sin and vi purvaka sin dhatu. So shin dhatu will become vi purvaka sin and then visinoti. Nyakara is an it letter, so see visinoti badhnati iti vishayaha. So it is a vishaya. What does it do? It binds you. Therefore it is called as vishaya. Iti vishayaha tasya vishayase ityartha. Atmani anatma tadharmadhyaso mitya bhavatu. So now Purvapakshi has given up his further objections to adhyasa of anatma yushmat pratyagochara anatma vishaya on asmat pratyagochara atma vishayi. Okay, let it be so. So he says atmani anatma tadharmadhyaso mitya bhavatu. Not only the anatma adhyasa but anatma dharma adhyasa was also questioned. Earlier he said, okay, let there be no adhyasa of anatma on atma, but why not anatma dharma adhyasa on atma? That was also refuted. Now he says, okay, I agree with both anatma and anatma dharmas, both cannot be adhyasa in atma. How about the other way around? Why is other way around not possible? Anatmani atma tad dharma adhyasa kim na syat? Why not so? Other way around can be possible. And what? Why does he suspect so? He says, I'll tell you. Aham spurami sukhi ityad yanubhavad ityashankya aha tad viparyena iti. And Bhagavan Bhashyakara says viparyena. As opposed to that, the other way around, vice versa also is not possible. Adhyasa mithya bhavitum yuktam. Other way round is what? Tad viparyena anatmani. Anatmani vishaye. You cannot have. So yushmat pratye gochare anatmani vishaye. Taddharmanam cha. So vishayi which is there. Which is yushmat pratye gocharasya. Sorry, I'll come back again. So what was said earlier is that in the asmat pratye gochara, so asmat pratye gochare yushmat pratye gocharasya, meaning in the vishayini vishayasya and taddharmanam adhyasa mithya bhavitum yuktam. Now the flip side is what? Yushmat pratye gochare anatmani vishaye atma dharma and atma, meaning what? Asmat pratye gocharasya asmat pratyagocharasya atmanaha tadharmanam cha adhyasa mithya bhavitum yuktam. So if you split them into two sentences, tat tad viparyena is also there. As opposed to what has been said, vice versa is also not possible. So now the question is, why not? It is possible. Aham spurami sukhi. When you say aham spurami and sukhi, Nayayika will say sukha is atma dharma. And here you say aham spurami, aham ahankara spurami, there is spandana, spurana is there. This spurana is taking in the atma, then sukha is the antakkarana dharma or atma dharma. So you can take it both ways. Ahankara spurami if you say, by Nayayika's thinking, if you say aham, and then sukhi, sukhattvam is atma dharma. That is superimposed on antakkarana. So antakkarana is what? Anatma. So anatmani ahankare, spurami iti ahankare, sukhi, this sukhi is atma dharma. Sukhattvam is atma dharma, so it should be in the atma. That is superimposed on anatma. So this is from the Nayayika's perspective. Or you can take it any which way, where you see that in the ahankara, let's say there is sukha. By the Vedantist perspective, sukha. But where is the bhana? Aham spurami is atma. So this is Vedanti paksha. Objection can be seen in both ways. Vedantist paksha is what? Aham spurami. The atma has swaprakasha spurana. Sukhatvam is there in antakkarana. Vritti sukha is there in vishaya sukha. All this is in antakkarana. So antakkarane सुख अस्ति इति अंतकरण सुखी, नॉट दीर्घ सुखी नपुंसक अंतकरण, अंतकरणम इज नपुंसक, देयरफॉर वी विल मेक इट ह्रस्व एंड विल से सुखी, दैट शुड बी द रियल केस, बट देन यू एंड अप विद अ दीर्घ अहम सुखी. देयर व्हाट इज हैपनिंग दैट स्पुरण विच इज देयर नाउ हियर सुख इज देयर इन द अंतकरण, दिस पूर्ण इज देयर इन द आत्मा, आत्मस्पुरण अपियर्स टू बी देयर इन द अंतकरण. So therefore, in anatma antakkarana, atma tadharma adhyasa kim na syat. And sukhattvam can also be taken as what? You can take it as sukha as ananda surupa atma. And thereby, this purana and sukhattvam, and this is swarupa, swarupa dharma, they are adhyastha in anatma ahankara. The reason I brought in the Nayayika's paksha and explained both is because the tikakara may look into it. However, what do you see in ahankara, atma and atma dharma adhyasa by aham? Aham, mukhyatvena it should be atma, but aham you use in the case of antakkarana also. So, atma adhyasa has taken place in antakkarana and atma dharma adhyasa, spurana, sukhattvam, this has taken place in anatma. Or sukhattvam can be the antakkarana dharma itself, we'll set it aside, but spurana is not antakkarana dharma, it is आत्मधर्म स्वरूप धर्म चैतन्यत्वात् तस्यैव चैतन्य स्वरूपत्वात् इत्यादि अनुभवाद् इत्याशंक्य तद्विपर्येण इति दिस रिफ्यूटेशन इज डन इन दी भाष्य तस्माद् तद्विपर्य व्हाट इज तद्विपर्य तत् इज तस्मात् सो तस्माद् अनात्मनः एंड तस्मात् कस्मात् तत् मीन्स आत्मा एंड तस्मात् मीन्स आत्मनः सो तस्माद् आत्मनः विपर्ययः तद्विपर्ययः विरुद्ध स्वभाव चैतन्यम. सो व्हाट इज इट तद्विपर्य, विपर्य इज विरुद्ध स्वभाव. सो विरुद्ध स्वभाव इज विरुद्ध आत्मनः विरुद्धम आत्मनः विरुद्धः स्वभावः यस्य चैतन्यस्य तच्चैतन्यम विरुद्ध स्वभावः आत्मा एक्चुअली एंड दैट आत्मा इज चैतन्यम. पुल्लिंग यू शुड ब्रिंग अ पुल्लिंग हियर बिकॉज विरुद्ध स्वभावः हैज बीन मेंशनड. Or you make it napunsakalinga for chaitanyam and say virudha svabhavaha yasya anatmana. So here that is anatma. So atmanaha virudha svabhavaha tasmad anatmana. I'm sorry. So I don't know what I read here. Tasmad anatmana. So in the vritti, while saying the vritti, tasmad is tat is anatma. So tasmad anatmanaha विपर्ययः सो विरुद्ध कस्माद् विरुद्ध अनात्मनः विरुद्ध स्वभावः यस्य चैतन्यस्य तच्चैतन्यं विरुद्ध स्वभावम् और यस्य आत्मनः सः आत्मा विरुद्ध स्वभाव एंड सः आत्मा तच्चैतन्यं यः आत्मा तच्चैतन्यं इत्थं भावे तृतीया. सो बाय स्वरूप इत्थं भावे तृतीया देयर इज दिस चैतन्य उपलक्षित आइटम्स. So ittam bhave tritiya tad viparyayena which is mentioned there viparyena this viparyayena this viparyaya this viruddhatvam is its very swabhava. So you can say viparyaya viparyayena tritiya ittam bhave tritiya means viparyayena is upalakshana upalakshita viparyena upalakshitah atma anatmanah viparyayena उपलक्षितः यः आत्मा तच्चैतन्यम् सो दैट इज इत्थं भावे तृतीया ठीक स्फुरामि इत्यनेन आत्माध्यास सुखी इत्यनेन अनात्मा अनात्म धर्माध्यास सी स्फुरामि इत्यनेन आत्माध्यास सो व्हेन यू से अहंकार हैज स्फुरण देयर यू नो दैट आत्मधर्म स्फुरण स्फुरामि that is atma swarupa that is showing the atma adhyasa on the anatma then sukhi ityanena atma dharma adhyasa iti viveka so sukhi there aham sukhi meaning sukhi when you say sukham asya asti iti sukhi सो सुखम इज देर देर दी आनंद स्वरूप आत्मा सुख स्वरूप आत्मा धर्म ऑफ दी सुखा इज लुक्ड एट दी धर्म ऑफ आत्मा देन आत्म धर्माध्यासा हैज टेकन प्लेस इन अनात्मा इति विवेकः. So to contrast with the Nayayika, here it has been mentioned that Sukha is not Nayayika's Sukha, which is the Atma Dharma. But here, this Sukha is Ananda. If you take it as, you can take it as Nayayika's Sukha also, just to refute the Nayayika. But here we are showing Sukha is what? Is Ananda manifest in Atma. It is manifest. Due to association, there is a manifestation in the Antakkarana really. But it is, Antakkarana cannot have Ananda. It is the manifestation of the Sukha of the Atma in Antakkarana. The Nayayaka will say it the other way around. Sukha is Atma Dharma for the Nayayaka and then it manifests in the Antakkarana. However, we will say that Sukha is not Guna, it is not Guna of Atma. Jnana, Sukha, these are not Gunas. These are Swarupa which manifests there in the Antakkarana. Anyway, however it is, this Spurana shows the Atma being superimposed, Adhyastha in Anatma, and Sukhi shows that the Atma Dharma being Adhyastha in Anatma. Iti Viveka. इत्तम भावे इति वैशिष्ट्यम इत्यर्थ. सो देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर वैशिष्ट्यम हियर इज व्हाट इज दैट प्रकृते वैशिष्ट्यम नाम अभेदः. सो इत्तम भावे हियर इत्तम भावे उपलक्षित व्हाट इट इज सो इट इज द वेरी वननेस दैट हैज दैट द वननेस दैट यू सी इन विपर्यय देयर विद दी विपर्य इट इज दी अभेद. सो अभेदे तृतीया और इत्तम भावे तृतीया दैट इज हाउ इट इज मेंशन. बट हियर व्हाट इज दिस वैशिष्ट्यम हियर वैशिष्ट्यम इज अभेद नाम अभेद सतद विपर्येण हियर इज तस्माद विपर्येण अनात्मना विपर्येण विरुद्ध स्वभाव स्वभाव. सो दैट स्वभाव इज इत्तम भाव रियली दिस इज हाउ आई वुड लाइक टू सी इट. Nonetheless, as long as you get the idea, it's okay. Those who have studied Vyakarana, they know what Ittam Bhava means. It is sometimes used loosely to indicate this Abheda or Swabhava, whereas technically it is used to be used when there is a, like in the cases of Jatavi Sadhu, Kamandulana Chhatraha. In those cases, the Tritiya is Ittam Bhave, meaning Kamandulana Upalakshitaha Chhatraha. So that is Ittam Bhave technically. But it is used in the other sense also. There may be Vartikas for those. So one who has Jata, it shows that Jata is there. So he must be a Sadhu. How do you know? Because Jata is there. So Jatavi Upalakshitaha Sadhu. That's how the Ittam Bhave Tritiya works. Pratna Prabha Chaitanyatmana. Chaitanyatmana Vishayinaha तद्धर्माणां च यः अहंकारादो विषये अध्यासः स मिथ्या इति नास्ति इति भवितुं युक्तम्. सो मिथ्या मीनिंग वाज एक्सप्लेन्ड एज हियर एज नास्ति इट इज नॉट देयर एट ऑल शुडंट बी देयर इट इज फॉल्स. सो चैतन्यात्मना विषयिणः तद्धर्माणां च यः अहंकारादो विषये अध्यासः द सेंशियंस दैट यू सी इन अहंकार विच इज not the ahankara zone, it is vishayi atmas chaitanya atmas swarupa which is adhyastha by brahma on the ahankaradi anatma. It shouldn't happen because of so much of virodha shown. Therefore if you see there is an adhyasa, that adhyasa is mithya nasti ityartha tad dharmanam cha ahankara. So all this is the same as the earlier, similar to earlier, it's just the opposite side. Nahi atra purva pramahita samskara sadrishyam ajnanam va asti. Now for this kind of an adhyasa to take place, what is the samagri needed? For any adhyasa earlier, samagri was mentioned. पूर्व पक्षी हैड सेड सच कैंड ऑफ सामग्री इज नॉट देयर. इन द केस ऑफ इदम अंश ऑफ द शुक्ति हैविंग अध्यास ऑफ रजत देर पूर्व प्रमाहित संस्कार इज देर. पूर्व प्रमा जन्य संस्कार इज देर. वॉट इज दैट पूर्व प्रमा? इदम रजतम इन द शॉप और एट योर होम वेर एवर यू सीन रियल सिल्वर व्यावहारिक रियल सिल्वर दैट सिल्वर हैज हैड सामानाधिकरण्य विद द इदम. इट हैज हैड इन योर अनुभव एंड दैट अनुभव हैज लेफ्ट अ संस्कार हैज लेफ्ट अ वासना दैट इदम कैन बी कंफ्यूज वेर एवर यू सी इदम दैट कैन बी कंफ्यूज विथ रजत सिल्वर. दैट इदम अंश इज नॉट द सिल्वर अंश इन द केस ऑफ शुक्ति रजत देर पूर्व प्रमाहित संस्कार इज देर एंड सम दोषा ऑल्सो शुड बी देर. दैट दोषा इज देर यू डू नॉट सी द शुक्ति ए शुक्ति. सो शुक्ति अंश ऑफ द शुक्ति इज नॉट नोन दैट इज द दोषा. इदम अंश ऑफ द शुक्ति इज नोन बट दैट इदम अंश कैन बी कंफ्यूज विद द संस्कार इदम अंश. दैट संस्कार इज ड्यू टू दैट इदम रजतम संस्कार. सो यू हैव दीज सामग्रीज अवेलेबल. देर मे बी अदर दोषाज ऑल्सो प्रमातृगत द्रष्टृगत दोष प्रमातृगत दोष इज देर एज टू दिस पर्सन वॉन्ट्स रजत. ही हैज क्रेविंग फॉर सिल्वर and that is running at the top of his mind. This is an old scenario where rupya, what we call today as rupees, there is all rupya, all that was made of silver as well. So it was made of silver, gold, etc. So silver is quite commonly used. So then that rupya, desire for money is there, that is in the form of rupya, in the form of rajata. So that is running at the back of the mind, and then that dosha also makes him see rajata whenever something shines. So sadrishyam is also there. Sadrishya is another samagri. The silver shines, whereas the shell also, when the sunlight, bright sunlight falls on the inside of the shell, there is a sign. So sadrishya is there. Pura pramahita samskara is there. And ajnana of the shukti is there. And then to add on, also raga towards rajata is also there in the pramatrigata dosha. So these are all samagris which are there. But in this case, what is the samagri? Anatma, to be seen as atma, what is the samagri there? You don't have purva pramahita samskara. You have never seen anatma as atma. Never seen in sense? By yatharta anubhava. There should be prama, there prama janita it should be, meaning yatharta anubhava it should be there. Not ayatharta anubhava is the argument of the purva pakshi, which actually does not hold basis. As I had mentioned, it is refuted elsewhere, and then the summary is given in the Vichara Sagara, which we saw in the earlier pathas. Nonetheless, this samagri isn't there. Is sadrishyam there? No sadrishyam is there. Between atma and anatma, all virodha only so far we have seen. There is no sadrishya. Then, what about dosha? What dosha? Sadrishya dosha, sadrishya ajnana. That sadrishyam or ajnanam va nasti. Pura pramahita samskaraha nasti. Atra hi. Yato hi. Yasmat karana atra asmin vishaye. Pura pramahita samskaraha nasti. There is no aikya samskara. Sadrishya isn't there. Ajnana isn't there. So sadrishyam nasti, ajnanam va nasti. Why ajnana isn't there? You know anatma. You know ahankara. You know atma also. Everyone says I know myself. Nobody says I do not know myself. Laukika drishtya. But here primarily you also know anatma. Definitely you know anatma. You know your body, you know your antakkarana, so you know your ahankara. Even in the Rudhi Artha of Ahankara, one knows whether one is egoistic or not. One may tell others that I have no ego, but one knows one has ego. But the real fact here is that Ahankara means individuality. You know that you are an individual. Compared to others, you are a separate person, entity, you know that. Even as a yogi, you may say, I am not this body, mind, sense complex, but I am different from the other. Who is also free from body, mind, sense complex? So you know Atma, you know Anatma also. So there is no Ajnana. Thereby, Samagri lacking, what will happen? Now, you don't have any basis for Adhyasa. Therefore, Mithya Bhuvitam Yuktam. Atma and Atma Dharma Adhyasa on Anatma is also Mithya. Why can't Sadrishya be there? Sadrishya is possible only when Sadrishya is between what? When we give a drishtanta, there is Sadrishyam. So, in the any Anumana also, you give drishtanta. It is like this, it is like that. So, what are you comparing? Obviously, not every feature is same. Some parts are same. Or some guna is same. So, either avayava is similar. By similarities, by avayava being same, some parts being same, or some gunas being same. Now, this Atma is nirguna and niravayava. So, how can you have sadrishya between Atma avayava being same with Anatma avayava? Atma part of Atma is same as part of Anatma, Ahankara, or Atma Guna. Atma Guna you cannot talk about because Atma is Nirguna. Therefore, Niravayava Nirguna Swaprakashatmani. This Swaprakashatmani and Swaprakashatvam of Atma is opposed to Jadatva of. So, Jadatva and Swaprakasha, there is no Sadrishyam. Avayava sadrishyam is not possible because Atma is niravayava, although Anatma is savayava. Atma is nirguna, whereas even if Anatma is saguna, Atma is nirguna. So you cannot have guna-wise comparison and show sadrishyam. You cannot have part-wise comparison and show sadrishyam. And swaprakashatvam and jadatvam are anyway not sadrishya. Therefore, gunavayava sadrishyasya cha ajnanasya cha ayogat. Since this sadrishya by avayava or guna is not possible and ajnana is not possible because you know what is ahankara, you know what is atma. Therefore, mithya bhavitam yuktam adhyasa of atma and atma dharmas on anatma. Tika. Chaitanyatmana iti. Chaitanyatmana sthitasya ityartha. So that which is existent in the form of the satta and spurti go together. So the chaitanya atmana sitasya ityartha adhyasasya iti atadrupe tadrupa avabhasah adhyasah. What is adhyasa? So tikakara says, oh, this adhyasa word has been used, but in what sense it is being used? That is going to come up in the bhashya further as to what all are the understood meanings of adhyasa and what is the Siddhanta Paksha? But in any case, whatever is the Adhyasa, it is anyway seeing something where it does not belong. So, Atasmin Tadbuddhi Adhyasa, says Bhagavan Bhashyakara in the Adhyasa Bhashya. Atasmin Tadbuddhi. That which is Atat, in that Tat, notion of Tat, meaning that which isn't, something which isn't that, in it seeing thatness. What does it mean? So in a non-sarpa rajju, seeing a sarpa. Atasmin asarpe rajjau sarpa buddhi adhyasa. So adhyasa is seeing sarpa in a non-sarpa. In a rope which is a non-snake, seeing a snake is adhyasa. So generally we call it, you know, translate as superimposition, but it's better to hold on to the word adhyasa itself now. So adhyasa sa nasti iti vaktum yuktam iti bhava. So it isn't there. So it is appropriate to say this adhyasa is not there. Samagri karana samudayaha sa nasti iti upapadayati. This samagri, the ingredients to make up this adhyasa aren't there. They are lacking. Therefore, if at all there is an adhyasa, that adhyasa isn't there. It is false. Niravayava iti. सादृश्यम द्विविधम, देर इज अ सादृश्यम, सिमिलैरिटी इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स, अवयव सादृश्यम गुण सादृश्यम च इति। इधर यू कैन शो सिमिलैरिटी बाय सिमिलैरिटी इन पार्ट्स, सिमिलैरिटी बाय सेमनेस इन पार्ट्स रियली, और सिमिलैरिटी ऑल्सो यू कैन से हाउ एवर यू अंडरस्टैंड यूर सेम एंड सिमिलर, और बाय गुण सादृश्यम, गुण बीइंग सेम, सम ऑफ द गुणास बीइंग सेम, तथा च निरवयवत्वाद अवयव सादृश्य रूप निर्गुणत्वाद गुण सादृश्यम रूपंच कारणम आत्मनि नास्ति। देयरफॉर व्हाट निरवयवत्वात् अवयव सादृश्य रूप एंड निर्गुणत्वात् गुण सादृश्य रूप कारण सामग्री इजंट देयर, आत्मनि नास्ति, आत्मा डज नॉट हैव गुण आल्सो एंड डज नॉट हैव अवयव आल्सो, देयरफॉर यू कैन नॉट शो एनी कंपैरिजन बिटवीन पार्ट्स और गुणास। स्वप्रकाशत्वाद अज्ञान रूप कारणम च आत्मनि नास्ति इति भाव, यू कैन नॉट से दैट आई डू नॉट नो आत्मा, यू नो इन एवरी कॉग्निशन, इवन व्हेन यू से आई डू नॉट नो दैट आई, हु इज दैट आई, यू नो द आई हु सेज आई डू नॉट नो, सो दैट आई यू नो, वॉट एवर यू नो यूर सेल्फ एज दैट इज द आई, so when you say I do not know, whoever understands I, however one understands I, one knows I do not know I, that is a contradiction. So when you say I do not know myself, that I is separated from the myself kind of a self, so the understanding of myself and understanding of I should be different. However, at least one is there. It may not be the mukhya artha, the real artha, but nobody says, even when one says, I do not know myself, I do not myself rightly is the meaning there. What I know, I am not that guy. I am not that kind of an entity. Thereby, who am I and all is possible. But then, when I is known, how can you say, I do not know? And in the case of Siddhanta, anyway, Atma is Swaprakasha, Chaitanya being Swaprakasha, no one can say, I do not know myself. Even in the wrong notion that Swaprakashatvam is there, which lights up the others, and then there is a tie-up with something and there is a bhranti. Thereby ajnana is not possible, which is also samagri karana for this adhyasa not being there. The samagri not being there, this adhyasa isn't there. Samskaro nasti ityatra purvokta hetu reva veditavya. The earlier hetu which was mentioned, which I mentioned in the Ratna Prabha also, that continues to be in the samskara lacking. Nirgunatvam dharmarahityam. What is that? Purvoktam. Purvokta hetu was in the case of the flip side, which was discussed earlier, as to in atma, anatma adhyasa and anatma dharma adhyasa is not possible because of what? Samskara isn't there. Such samskara isn't there. You are never seen anatma as atma. This was said earlier. Now, same thing should be repeated with the flip side as you have never seen anatma as atma. So that samskara isn't there. Prama as yatharta anubhav you have never had. Nirgunatvam dharma raityam iti matva shankate. Now nirgunatvam is dharma raityam. I'll just take this pura paksha and stop. Nirgunatvam, now you have said nirgunatvam, so that there is some continuity. Nirgunatvam, you are talking of atma being nirguna. And then you are talking of, what is that nirgunatvam? Dharma rahitya. Dharma not being there. Atma is nirguna dharma rahita iti matva shankate. Now, there is a question, there is an objection to this. Nanu atmanah nirgunatve tad dharmanam iti bhashyam katam iti ched uchyate. If you say atma is nirguna, you say, Shruti says atma is nirguna, and now you are talking about tadharma adhyasa, you are refuting it. Whether you are refuting it or what, whether you are refuting it or you are saying that it is possible, whether adhyasa of dharma, atma dharma on anatma is possible or it is not possible, that discussion itself is nishprayojaka. Why would you discuss something which is an impossibility? Not by logical thinking, but just by knowing that Atma is Nirguna, meaning Nirdharmaka. Nirdharma, Nirdharmaka Atma इट्स तद्धर्माणाम आत्मधर्म दैट प्रयोग इटसेल्फ इज इनकरेक्ट व्हेन आत्मा इज निर्गुण मीनिंग हैविंग नो धर्म देन तद्धर्म आत्मधर्म यूजेज दैट भाष्यम द यूजेज ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स दिस फ्रेज इन द भाष्य इटसेल्फ इज अनटेनेबल कथम हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल व्हाई डू वी यूज सच लैंग्वेज निर्गुण आत्मा गुणा कैन नॉट बी सुपर इम्पोज ऑन अनात्मा एंड देन द डिस्कशन इज देयर ऑन द धर्म ऑल्सो एनालिसिस इज देयर इट इज ऑल फ्यूटाइल व्हाई बिकॉज आत्मा इज से आत्मा इज निर्गुण निर्धर्म देन व्हाई डू यू डिस्कस इज आत्मधर्म इन अनात्मा दैट डिस्कशन इज फ्यूटाइल वील लुक एट दी मोर डिटेल्स इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट यमिह कारुणिकं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहं आशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचांकम अनंत सुखाकृतिं ओम तत्सत एनी क्वेश्चंस नमस्ते
नमस्ते